This is Dr. Vikas. And how you could make the tips? Hey everyone, this is Dr. Vikas. In this video, we're going to discuss your financial health and how you could save money, utilize your money well, as well as make your money grow. So watch the video right to the end. So what are the first and foremost thing we need to do? We need to plug the leaks. We need to plug the holes. Do you need all those mobile connections? Do you need the same amount of data? Are you using it all? Or can you downsize your data plan? Is it possible? Like for example, you may be using a caller tune and you don't actually need it. Do you really watch all those channels on your dish TV? Are you utilizing the entire connected load on your electricity bill? Do you need Netflix and Prime Video and Sony Live and Zee TV subscriptions? Do you need them all? How many do you have? Can you give up some of them? Do you need that club membership? Do you have a subscription to a holiday resort which you're not using because no one's traveling nowadays? Do you need that lounge membership, the VIP lounge at the airport? Can you talk to your company? Maybe there's some saving there which you haven't explored. So basically, you need to look at every subscription, every installment that you're paying, whether it's a monthly, quarterly, weekly, yearly, whatever. Look at each one of them and see if you can give up any of those or downsize any of those, because every saving counts. Do you know what a power factor device is? It's a device that you install in a household and it increases the power factor. For example, if your power factor is currently, let's say, 0.7 or 0.75, and you can make it go to 0.85, that's a huge 15-20% jump in your power factor and an equal amount of reduction in your electricity bill. Are you using a water heater? Are you using a geyser? Are you using an AC? There might be some hidden saving there which you haven't explored. So are you still overstocking? Because this scarcity is not going to happen for a long time. Now, at least Delhi is not happening. So don't need to overstock. Is there a possibility of growing some produce in your house? Can you grow your own cabbage? Can you grow your own tomatoes? Can you grow your own spinach? Consider exploring that possibility, because you'll be getting fresh produce, you'll be getting homegrown produce, and at the same time, you'll be saving some money. So the basic idea is that you need to spend some time in studying all the possible ways that you're leaking funds, and you need to plug every one of them, no matter how small. Try to cook at home as much as possible. It's healthier in the current situation and it's less risky, and it also saves you some money. A lot of people don't understand the word investment very well. When they buy a new vehicle, they call it an investment. When they buy a new mobile, they call it an investment. Well, it is not. Unless you're using that device to make more money, it's not an investment, because it's a depleting asset. The mobile worth is X today, it'll be X minus something tomorrow, and then it'll keep reducing. So investments don't deplete, they grow. So if you're buying a car, if you're buying an electronic device, they're all expenditures, they're not investments. So if you're buying real estate, that should be an investment, but in some situations even that is kind of currently depleting, but that's a very temporary phenomena. But electronic devices and vehicles will never increase in their value unless they become vintage. You have to wait 50, 70, 80 years for the value to go up. An insurance policy is not an investment. It's a risk cover. So if you have a perceived risk and you want to cover that, then you should buy an insurance policy. For example, if you invested the same amount of money in some other debt or some other equity, you probably might make more money. But the insurance policy will cover a risk, whether it's a health insurance or whether it's a vehicle insurance or whether it's a life insurance, it'll cover a risk. Don't get all those features which you did take earlier, because you're not driving as much and you need to save money right now. So try and downsize your insurance policies and try and talk to your insurance company to see how you could save. I'm sure they have some ideas. So you all know about risk appetite. So there are people who are willing to take risks and the people who are not willing to take risks. So people who don't take risks will normally invest in debt. Debt means fixed deposits and stuff like that. And those people who will take risks will invest in equity, like shares and all. Mutual funds are nothing but equity. It's an equity being managed by somebody else, like a pool of shares being managed by a mutual fund. So that is also equity. But many mutual funds will allow you to distribute your investment in debt and equity up to a percentage that you want. So currently, all the equity is kind of not doing so well. So a lot of people are moving their investments towards debt. So you can also consider doing that if you want to cover the risk. It totally depends on your risk appetite. If you have invested in equity and you see any price falling, they normally say that whenever any price is falling, you sell. Don't wait for the price to stop falling and to rise and then you sell. Maybe it's fallen from 100 rupees to 70 rupees today and you think, no, it's going to stop, it's going to bounce back, and it goes to 50 rupees, 30 rupees, 20 rupees, 5 rupees. So if you sell as early as you can, you minimize your risk. If you are investing in debt, then you can consider opening an account in the post office for several reasons. A, they give you a better percentage than banks. B, banks can and do fail. Post office will never fail. They are owned by the government, so a post office failing is not going to happen unless the government fails and the country fails. And if you have an elder, a senior person in the family, in whose name you can open a post office account, so you get an even better percentage. So you can consider doing that. So you'll save on taxes and you'll make a slightly better percentage. So now I'm coming to a totally different dimension. When we invest in growth of money and growth of finances. But there's one more thing you can invest in. You can invest in goodness. You can invest in charity. So they say that when a river starts out in the mountains, it's a very narrow stream. So throughout its journey to the ocean, it waters so many fields, it quenches the thirst of so many animals. Yet when it reaches the ocean, it's no longer a narrow stream, it's a huge river. So even though it gave and gave and gave throughout its journey, it doesn't lose its water, it only grows. So this is the same for human beings. The more you give in charity, the more you help people out, the more your money will grow. So it is prescribed that if you donate at least 10% of your earnings, not of your savings, of your earnings, so whatever money you earn this month, donate at least 10% of that. But beware, because a lot of charities out there which are not really honest. So check their finances, check the work that they're doing, or you can help directly. Like you can go to a slum area nearby, give them food. You can talk to your local police station and see if you can take their help in reaching out food to the poor and the needy. If you have any unused items in the house, like maybe an old bicycle, maybe a gym machine. So if you have anything that you haven't used for the last 6 months to a year, maybe an old camera, you can probably recycle them. There's a free cycle movement. You can check it. You can Google it. So somebody who needs your stuff will come and pick it up for free, and then he'll recycle it when he doesn't need it anymore. Mostly prams and kids stuff. You know, a lot of people only need them for a short period of time, and after that, these are useless. You know, when push comes to shove and you're in deep trouble, everybody only counts their blessings. Like in Hindi, they say that kisi ki dua kaam aage thi. What is this blessing that is going to help you out? This blessing is these blessings that we collect by helping needy people, by helping poor people. While you're still earning, while you still have the capability, try and do whatever best you can to earn this good karma. Because they say that finances are never permanent. So if tomorrow you're no longer capable, so then you won't even get the opportunity to earn good karma. They also say when an elephant is eating, he might drop some small particles here and there and you won't even notice them. But for an ant, that might be an entire feast for the entire family. So similarly for us, it may not even make a difference to our wealth or finances. And for somebody, it may be their entire life. Somebody, it may be a new hope. It's a very nice way of thinking that something that won't even matter to me can matter a lot to somebody else. So why not do it? So I'm sure I've missed out a lot of tips. So why don't you comment and write what other ways you can save money. Put it in the comment box below. And this is all for today. You have a good day, guys. Bye-bye. And how you can make the tips? Or can you down? Are you utilizing encryption? Maybe some, like so that's a huge 20%. You know. all the po- then you should it's always so it's you know why